Hello everyone, welcome to our today's webinar, How to Perform Churn Analysis for Your Mobile Apps. Before we begin, I will just go over some quick logistics for the webinar. Please make sure that your mic is muted and that you are able to listen to us properly. Also make sure you're able to view our screen being shared with you. We will be the recording of the webinar soon after the completion. If you have any questions during the course of the webinar, please send them via the chat window. Let me introduce myself. I am your host for today's webinar and my name is Shachipa. With us, we also have Murugesh Soni, our resident web analyst, who provides the insights and recommendations to improve the conversion rate. Hi Murugesh, shall we begin?
Sure. Thank you Shachi and thanks a lot everyone for taking out time for joining us today. Today I am going to spend some time to explain what is churn analysis and its application. In this webinar, we are focusing particularly on churn analysis for mobile apps. This will facilitate the mobile app analyst to target the right audience for retention and eventually it will help in boosting their revenues. Okay, so let's get rolling. So I'll walk you through the overview first, and which will provide the idea about what we are going to achieve today. So we'll begin with by understanding of what is churn analysis and the motivation behind churn analysis and its benefits. In short, we will understand the concept of churn analysis thoroughly. Now, any analysis can't be performed without the right data. So we will understand the data points required for churn analysis. How we can extract this data and how we can transform this data in order to build a better predictive model. Then we will discuss about why we are choosing predictive model, which machine learning algorithm will fuel our model, and how to build a predictive model. So I hope we are clear about the agenda.
Yes, Murugesh, we are. So is this how the whole agenda has been divided into three different perspectives, which are beginning with understanding of the churn analysis, followed by extraction process, and finally with the predictive model building?
Exactly. So without any further delay, let's get started with the churn analysis. Customer churn is a phenomena which observed across various industries like telecom, finance, and more recently in SaaS mediums. The term churn refers to the customer attrition. It is the process of identifying those customers who are most likely to discontinue the use of your either service or product. This entire process is known as churn analysis. It is a possible indicator of customer dissatisfaction. And therefore, it is important for business owner to identify those customers who are about to churn. And this is the goal of our today's webinar.
Okay, Murugesh. So if I'm an app owner, why would I perform churn analysis for my mobile app? What benefits would it have on my business?
Okay, great question, Shachi. So if we talk about mobile apps, the cost of customer acquisition is much higher than the cost of customer retention. Moreover, a customer might churn even before you are able to recover the acquisition cost. The typical signal that indicates a customer leaving your app is uninstallation of the app. And once a customer uninstalls your app, it becomes very late to apply the retention tactics. So we require a proactive approach where we are able to identify churning customer very much in advance. So now we'll look at the business perspective that will be fulfilled by churn analysis, which is reducing customer churn. This will be achieved by firstly predicting whether the customer will churn or not. Secondly, understanding why the customer will churn so that we can act accordingly in that direction. Let me also show the economic impact of churn on your business. It acts as an inhibitor to revenue growth. Hence, if we were able to reduce churn rate by half, this has a noticeable impact on your revenue.
Interesting fact. Can you elaborate on this maybe with an example?
Sure, Sachi. Why not? The graph depicted in this slide shows the impact of churn on overall revenue. Now, assume that there are two businesses, one having a 3% churn rate and the other has a 6% churn rate, month over month. And if we were to compare the revenue trajectories between both these businesses, it is evident that the company with the lower churn rate would emerge as a winner. So the business with a 3% churn rate has a 50% higher recurring revenue than the company with a 6% churn rate. And as the company grows, this effect becomes even more significant. So now, since we have a clear perspective of the impact of churn on revenue, let us think about a similar case for mobile application. It is, you know, widely known that since there are numerous mobile apps on app stores and we observe that user growth as a function of time, then the growth trajectory is linearly increasing. But after 3 months, the customer begin to churn and leave or uninstall your app. In fact, a statistics by mobile app analytics provider Flurry states that most of the apps lose half of their peak users within the 3 months of installation. So conventionally, a way to counter this is to keep on acquiring new users. If we look at the holistic picture, it is important not to just acquire new users, but to focus on existing users as well. Let me give you a little more idea about how we can prevent this. So if you see the green line in this diagram, which represents the churn user month over month, and the proportion of new users is remain constant. Now, carrying out churn analysis and focusing on the number of churned users has a great impact on the overall customer growth, which are in the blue line. Okay. So let's just understand this graph first. If you focus on the graph, then let's say in the beginning of first month, you have 1500 users. And by end of the month, you gain 500 new users and lost 300 users. So by beginning of the second month, you would be having 1700 users. And let's say this trend continues. And at the end of the 6 month, you might end up with fewer number of users than you started with. If you see the first month, we have total 1500 users. And by end of the 6 month, it comes to the 1272.
Okay. Correct me if I'm wrong, Rokesh, but here are we trying to conclude that if we decrease our churn rate, we would have high number of users at the end of 6 months, or will it have a substantial impact on revenue as well as customer growth?
Yes, definitely. If you see in the graph on the right side, post applying the churn analysis, which is after 3 months, there are significant increase in your graph. So you started with number of users, you have 1500, and by end of the 6 months, you are end up with the 2193 approx. So this is how churn analysis comes into the picture, and post applying churn analysis, you can see there are significant increase in your total subscription, even though you have prevent the churn.
Yes, that answers my question. Okay. Thank you.
So before we actually execute churn, let's understand how to begin with it. So first and foremost, identify the type of app you have. So over here, we tried to implement the churn analysis for any specific app. So I will give you more brief about what are the precautionary steps that we need to carry out over here. And for that, the first step is identify the type of app, which might be gaming, social, productivity or traveling app. Then identify the activities that user perform on your app. Identify the frequency of usage of core or very main features across your user base. And last, identify the average lifetime for your user base. So by doing this, you will get closer to know how users behave on your app. And this will help you to define at which specific moment you will call your user as a churner. So now this is little tricky, but let's understand this in little more detail. The first step that you need to define is the cutoff date. So cutoff date defines the date difference between the current date and the date when user last engaged with your app. For example, let's say user last interacted with your app on 9th of Feb 2014 and today is 19th March 2014. So if you take the difference in between these 2 days, it comes to the 40 days. So for this specific app, the cutoff date would be the 40 days. The other parameters that we can take into consideration is number of activities performed since the app was downloaded, how frequently user visited your app, the installation of your app, and whether user interacted with the core features on a regular basis or not, and so on. So eventually depending upon the nature of your app.
Okay. Wonderful. I'm clear with the idea of churn analysis and why I will perform that app and its outcomes. So I assume that our next step would be collecting the data to take our analysis into action.
Yes, correct. But before we move into that, let's just recall what we have discussed so far. So we understood what is churn analysis, what are the reason behind to carry out churn analysis, and what benefit that we can gain out of implementing the churn analysis. Okay. So before we build our model, there are three prior steps that we need to execute. And the first is variable selection. Second step would be data extraction. And third would be the data pre-processing part. We'll discuss each of these points in detail and we'll begin with first variable selection. Now, variable selection is a very key process in any analysis as it creates the base for your model. So there could be a lot of data points which help us in understanding our mobile app users for the purpose of churn analysis. If I talk from the higher level, then this variable could be segmented into user location, device specific features, in-app behavior and user actions. And corresponding to these four categories, we could have Google Analytics dimension and metrics like country, operating system, device category and so on. So this variable would be my input variable while I'm going to build my model. Okay. So once we done with the variable selection, the next step would be the data extraction part. But prior to that, let's say if you have a Google Analytics implemented on your mobile app and you want to build a predictive model to identify customers who are about to churn. So it is essential to implement Google Analytics on your mobile app to extract or to execute this process. And for this, we need to extract the data from Google Analytics and we get into this into our tool, which is R. So we'll now see how we can extract the data from Google Analytics using R. Let's say you are a user over here and the user needs to perform the authentication by exchanging a set of tokens with the API. This is the first step. Once that is done, the user will request the API to retrieve the list of profiles associated with your Google Analytics account. Then we will hit the query with the standard parameters like dimension, matrix, and date range. Okay, so this is how the process works from backend. This is not the tough or the very tricky process. It is quite simple. So to demonstrate that, let me jump into the R. So I'll switch to R. Okay. So this is how the GUI of R looks like. There are four sections, as you can see. The left section in which you're supposed to write your command and execute. Just underneath, there is a console window where you can see the result of your various commands. And on the right side, there is a list of profiles and data frames on which you are working. And on the end, you can download various packages and you can see where your various files are getting stored in your computer system. Okay. So I have already written the code in advance. And all we need to do is just execute step-by-step process, which we have just demonstrated using our graph. So the first step is to get the authorization from Google Auth server. And for that, I select the code and execute it. The moment I execute it, it will, as you can see, it is already directed into the server. Now I will click on accept. Okay. And it will take me to the Google Auth server, where I need to click on exchange authorization code for tokens, and I'll click on it. Okay. And in response, Google will provide me the access token, which you can see on the right hand side, or I can paste from here as well. Yes. So I'll select this and I'll copy and paste on the console window on R. So we have pasted the access token in R. Then we retrieve the list of profiles as a next step. And once we're done with that, you can see, you know, the various activities that we are doing over here. We can see the which data that we have retrieved over here. Yes, on the right hand side. Okay, the next step is we have the query build model on which we have selected the start date, end date, and dimension that I have selected is country, operating system, and device category. And in metrics, I have selected the exist. So you can see all this dimension and metrics that we have discussed in our variable selection slide. So this, it would be the reference for R that which metrics and dimension that we need to consideration. So I just run this, and to get this data, I'll run this command. Okay. Now let's say I have data with me, which I'm trying to extract, and I want to perform some transformation or want to calculate some additional metrics over here. And for that, I'll save this file or data frame into the CSV format by running this simple command write.csv, and it will convert my R file into the CSV format. So I hope that the process of data extraction is clear for our audience. If you guys have any question, you can feel free to ask through chat window, or you can ask post webinar as well. Okay. So what we have seen so far, let's recall quickly. We identify the set of variables that would help us to build the model. Then we extract the data from Google Analytics using R. And now we'll move to the data extraction, data pre-processing part. Okay. Our data pre-processing part is important in terms of building the model. So for that, I'll just switch into the Excel sheet. Okay. So there is a pre-request is over here prior to build the model, that in front of the each visitor ID, VID over here is representing the visitor ID. The dimension that I have selected from Google Analytics and metrics over here, it says that this visitor ID has performed this many activities in terms of metrics over here, and the country, operating system, and device are the various user behavior in front of each visitor ID. Additionally, I have calculated two different metrics or variable we can say, which are days since installed and days since last activity. Now let's understand this, why we need these two variables. Okay, so days since installed is nothing but the number of days since user installed your app, and days since last activity is number of days since the user has performed last activity on your app. There is a reason why to calculate these two metrics is it would help us to build the model, and it will eventually help us to categorize which variable we should consider as a churn or not. Now we'll define the condition. Now you just recall that while ago we have just discussed about what are the, I'll just go back and show you the criteria. So we have just discussed that what are the criteria that we need to define to the churn analysis. So I just use those criteria for my mobile app, and okay, for my app I have considered the criteria like if date difference day since last activity is greater than 30, then I will label those as a churner, which I have did in advance as well. So why we are discussing about this data set, because prior to build a model, it is request that we should have data in this format. This will help us to build the model. Okay, so this is very important in terms of data preparation part. We'll again jump back to the PowerPoint slide. Okay, so now we have data set with us, and the next question is why predictive model? Okay, and we'll answer this. Okay, so until now we have just extracted the data, then we transform it, and now we are trying to tackle the problem of predictive customers who are about to churn. So if you think on this detail, based on the data points that we have discussed earlier, we are trying to predict between two outcomes, whether a customer will churn or not. So this is a binary response, and we are trying to classify between these two outcomes in terms of yes or no, one or zero, likewise. And this is eventually nothing but the classification problem with respect to the machine learning algorithm. So we'll understand what is logistic regression over here. Okay, so logistic regression is the technique when you are trying to predict the binary output. Because in our case, there are only two possibilities, whether user will get churn or not get churn. So that's why we come up to the logistic regression. And in our case, the predictor variable is unique key or the visitor ID that I have shown you in my Excel file. Let me just show you again. So if you see this visitor ID, whether he is churn, and there are certain visitors who will not get churn. So this is how we are going to predict using our predictive model. Okay, let's get back to PPT again. So we have decided which machine learning algorithm that we are going to implement. But prior to that, we need to perform certain action in order to build the model more effective. So since we have touched upon the algorithms and understood the objectives behind modeling, and once the model is built, we would like to have an idea about how accurately it is able to predict. It is not only just to build the model, at the same time we need to check whether it is how accurate or what are the errors that we still have in our model. And in order to calculate the accuracy of metrics, we will divide our whole data set into two parts, which is known as train data set and test data set, in 70% and 30%. So eventually, now we build the model on a train data set and then ask this model to predict output on the unseen data set, which is the test data set. So I will now switch to R and implement all those steps in R to achieve our predictive model. Okay, so before we begin with the predictive model, I need to load certain libraries which will help me to build my model. Then I load the data file which I have. So as you can see, this is the Excel file on which I build the model. and I'll get this file into R. The first step is we need to split data set into 70% and 30%. So this command, this command will help me to split the data set into 70% and 30%. The next step is to build the logistic regression model. And for that, we use the GLM function, and GLM stands for generalized linear model. Now, in this point, we need to tell the function the response variable, which is labeled as churn in our case. So the syntax means that we build a model to predict churn as a function of all the rest of the variables in the data set. So I'll select all this command and run in a one go. Okay. Now I'll use the summary function, which allow me to explore the importance of each variable in predicting the outcome. So over here, what I'm trying to predict is whether my visitor will predict churn or not. So it will become my outcome variable over here. And we see that the day since last visit emerges as an important variable. It has the most influential variable among all. So this is how we can read the output from our console, which is really important in terms of which variable is affecting your end results. Once we run this model, now we'll run the same model on our test dataset as well. And prior to do that, I just need to store the actual labels from my test dataset to some other data frame. Okay, and I'll try to predict the model on our test dataset then. Okay, we've done this. Okay, and the next step would be we'll calculate the accuracy using confusion matrix over here. And if you see the confusion matrix over here, and the accuracy is 0.9934. Now you might be surprised with the accuracy over here, but as we are using the sample data, so we kind of having such high accuracy over here. So once we build the model, we need to find out how accurate our model is. And we can say that using our confusion matrix. So how to interpret this confusion matrix? I already take this confusion matrix into the PPT. So I'll just switch to my PPT. Okay, so here is my confusion matrix. Now, the confusion matrix compares the actual outputs to the predicted labels. Since in both the cases, we had two values, 0 or 1, where 0 and 1 represents the churn user and the non-churn user. So this is referring to the file where we have already declared our churn variables. And the model accuracy is the ratio of all the variables which predict the model correctly. So as you can see, we have predicted 620 churner correctly, and also we have predicted those users who are not going to churn. There are also 4 users who are not going to churn, but our model has predicted that it will get churn, and vice versa for those visitors who have only 7 visitors who are going to churn. Okay, so I'll just recall what we have did so far. We just understood the concept of churn analysis, its implications, how we get benefit out of it. And the next step, we extracted the Google Analytics data using R. Prior to that, we also discussed about why important it is to variable selection. And finally, we deal how to process with the data. Post that, in third section, we build the predictive model using our data. Then we calculate the confusion matrix, which will help us to identify how accurate our model. But this confusion matrix is only on our test data set. So now the question which here comes is, what we will do once we have the predictive model? Okay, in order to identify what kind of visitor will going to churn, and I have identified those. So what will be the next step that I need to do? So This slide will answer your questions. So I have just categorized all those users into the four different cycles depending upon the app usage life cycles. So first are the sensor, who are those users who have just installed the app and have not interacted sufficiently with the app. Or in other words, we can say they have hardly tried any of the features which your app have. Secondly, we have the activators who did few activities, but they are better than the sensors. And the one who have interacted with the app out of the curiosity and use or tried few or more variables. The third one are engaged. This set of users are those users who use your app infrequently, but never technically stop the use of your app. And last but not the least, the loyalists, which are the frequent users. So the purpose of segmentation is to be able to communicate with each of these categories effectively. And with churn prediction, you can have measurement of probability for each of these categories. I'll just go back for a moment and we'll discuss why we are doing all these processes. Okay, once we define the churn analysis, how we identify the users, what we are going to deal with this, what are the approach that we need to take into consideration, and that is why we have divided the whole segmentation. Okay. So as you can see, we have already classified those users into four categories based upon their app interaction. We will now see how to guide individual set of users in order to prevent them from churning. Because ultimately that would be our goal, how to prevent the existing customer become the churn. So in case of search, what effort we need to make is we make to them aware about functionality of the app and how app can benefit from them. What all the features app provide. So this we can consensus into the activators. Now for activators, we need to make them aware about key features of the app which might interest them. Along with that, they should be given more guidance on about how to use your app more frequently. The engaged user, for them we need to make transformation into the loyalist, and we need to motivate them to use our on a more frequent basis. Finally, we have the loyal users, and for loyal users we need to make a multiple channels for communication for them, and due to their stringent frequency we can provide them various bonuses or coupons to maintain this set of users as our happy loyalists. So in the end, what I'll conclude is, I hope I have been able to convey the concept of churn analysis clearly and why we need to implement the same and what outcomes should be expected and how those outcomes will benefit us.
Yes, Lokesh, I am sure that our audience is also totally convinced about why churn analysis should be implemented and what outcome can be expected out of it. I hope this webinar will help our attendees carry out churn analysis for their apps and see the positive difference in their customer base as well as revenue. Thank you, Mrugesh. That was really helpful. I hope the audience enjoyed it as well. Our audience has few questions. The first question is, can I test the model on the same data set as it was trained on?
I think it's an interesting question from a data analyst point of view. So let me just repeat what you just asked me, that can I test the model on the same data set as the one it was trained, right?
Right.
Yeah. So ideally we won't recommend to build the model and run as well as on the same data set. The reason behind this is the accuracy of model. And it is preferable to test your model on unseen data set as well. And that is why we run initially on our trained data set and we tried our model on test data set. I hope I answer your question or the audience question.
I hope the audience is convinced too. Even one of our attendees asked that, are there any other algorithms apart from logistic regression to carry out churn analysis?
Apart from logistic regression, mostly data scientists usually prefer random forest and support vector machine. And we can run different models on the same data set and select the models with the highest accuracy matrix. As you can see in our previous slide, we have the model accuracy around 99.34%. So we can use all these methods, and whichever method has the highest model accuracy, we can take those methods into consideration.
Okay, I guess we should look into that more. Okay, sure. The next question is very interesting. One of our attendees has asked, how many conditions should I declare my user as churned for my app?
There can be multiple conditions for the user to churn, and this also needs to be tweaked for improving your model in a way that. So it completely depends upon the nature of your app and the user behavior.
That would be great. We will be answering the rest of the questions via email. At this point, let me thank all of you for attending the webinar. Recording of the webinar will be available on our website along with the script and the data used during the webinar. Thank you for attending today's webinar, and we will keep you updated about our upcoming webinars. Have a great day.